Ever once timber giant Bigfoot? No, your eyes aren't deceiving you. It's a fat bike. You know, to make it perfectly clear, the bike didn't come from a viewer. Rather, it came from some family members and a friend who, I guess, really truly believe what I'm doing here. So to them, to Ralph and Kia, thank you very much for the machine. As you can see, it's doing the job. Although I don't know if I picked a very good day to come out here. It's terrible though. It's nice and quiet here, but we'll see what happens when I get farther up. Oh boy. You know, it's Kia is the kind of person who sees the things I show her and say, you know, what do you think of this? Let's stop and talk about this. I say, you know, take a look at this. She says, what, have you seen anything new? I'll show her what I think is a face or a creature moving. I'll say, do you see it? And after a lot of time, she'll say, yeah, maybe. And Ralph, on the other hand, he doesn't have any input on anything. He looks at stuff and says, oh yeah, one of those kind of silent people, I guess. But when it came right down to it, and they found out that, you know, something like this. Oops. I found out that I really needed this thing, this bike. Well, they stepped up and made it possible. Mind you, I had a little input on this too. I'm by no means wealthy, but together we made this happen. So to them, thank you very much. I'll put this thing to good use. It's the newest member of the Timber Giant Bigfoot team of pieces of equipment, I guess we'll call it. And, you know, it really figures too, because the road out here, someone's come along here and plowed it once. But still, we wouldn't be able to ride on this with the other bikes. I've tried before, so I end up walking on this all the time. But this thing, it just sails right over it. We'll see how far back in the forest I can sail. Hopefully I can make it back there. I haven't made it as far back in the forest as I normally come, but we're right through here. And lo and behold, I stopped right here. So, anyway, it's the bike's first adventure out here. I could ride this whole trail, but I'm pretty tired from riding out here. I don't want to kill myself. Right over there. There's a cave right there. I don't see any tracks and stuff around it. And I can barely see what I'm looking at here in the viewfinder prism. Right there. That's a cave in there. It's quite deep too. Lots of animal tracks. And it's really windy. Luckily it's not snowing right now. I really feel weird just leaving that bike back there. Believe me, I certainly can't afford to replace that. So the viewer that's in the UK somewhere who was offering the bicycle, all I do is pay for shipping. I appreciate the offer, but as you can see, I've now got a bike, so thank you for the offer. If another one shows up, well, I guess we'll have to give that one to Bryce. There's another cave right down there. It's not very easily seen, but it's there. And I've always wondered if the two caves are connected. And if you look along the top of the hill over there, there's a trail. Animals have been walking along over there. I'm not sure if it's picking it up. You can see it right over there. The trail along the top. I don't see it going towards the caves at all, but I do see footprints over here around this entrance. They don't look like they really go to it though. Holy moly, my hot. It's really cold out. I'm working really hard to get out here. I typically wouldn't have come out on a day like this, but I was all wound up about this bike, you know. Just got it yesterday. Lots of tracks down there. Holy crap. Look at that. I imagine those are mostly deer tracks. Way down there across into creek. They go up the far side over there. A lot of them are the pine trees. Mostly deer eating the pines. Sure how far this way I'm gonna walk. So today's adventure, little journey, is already taken. It's 11:30. It's taken an hour and a half to get out here, even riding that awesome bike. Mind you, I'm going through snow drifts in spots and all kinds of stuff. And the bad thing is I'm riding with the wind to get here. On the way home, I gotta ride directly into the wind, and that's not gonna be good. So today's visit to the forest is gonna be just that. It's the visit to the forest. Here's where you see me walking the last time I was out here. This is my trail. Well, the whole thing is my trail. I'm surprised it's not all drifted in after the amount of snow we had this morning. I've been out here a few times, but absolutely nothing to film. The last time I came out here, the battery in the camera just plain old died. Hopefully that doesn't happen again. I lost the entire chunk of footage. Look at this. It's a big impression here. Another one here. Look at that. It's almost like it is the shape of a foot. The toes are up there. What the heck? Holy crap. Another one here. Another one here. I don't have a measuring tape or any of that stuff with me. Look at this one. You can actually see where the bend in the foot would have been. Wow, look at this, he just walked in a perfect line right along here. Holy, that's impossible. Look how bloody, look how huge this footprint is. Look, there's my foot. Well, this is not a very good one, you can't see the end of it very well. See that? I mean, holy cow. Look at this. You know, let's just, look at this. Good Lord, look at the toe marks here. Look, here's my stride. Look, way up to that one. There you go. I can't even, there's no way I can reach that. Holy. Wow, look at that. They weren't here 2 days ago. That was the last time I think I was out here. And just presto, they're gone again as I walked on this trail. I was walking right on the trail in spots for the most part. Oh, look at that up here too. Holy. Wow. There's something big in this forest. Bigger than me. Just so people know, I'm 6'5". My legs are pretty long. And there's absolutely no way I can step in. If I was running, maybe I could probably run from one step to the other. Just walking along here, no way. I don't like it out here. The trees are all crashing, smashing, and bending all over the place. Wow. I wonder where the footprints came from. Obviously, they followed the trail. I'm not sure how far I want to walk out here, though. It's not like the trail is new. As you can see, I'm only wearing shoes. I'm not really terribly well prepared for walking in snow. Although I do have waterproof socks on. What a trade-off that is. I'm gonna keep going this way. I'm gonna turn the camera back on in a minute. See if I can find more interesting footprints. See some more. God. These trees don't fall down. Anyway, I've come back to these footprints here. What I'm suspecting are possible footprints. They certainly look like footprints. They've all been filled in with snow. I'm looking for, there's a left, right. The left is when I stepped in. Here's one. Right here. This is enormous. There you go. One, two, and a bit of my footprints inside of that. And the stride is huge. It's a good 40 inches between strides. And just so you know, that's a size 14 shoe. Wow. There are other possibilities. It could be a person walking out here in snowshoes that are shaped like feet. I haven't seen any of those. I've never seen anybody's footprints out here in snowshoes ever. These look like footprints. Wow, enormous stride. Holy. Well, there are associated footprints too. Through here. There's another one here, even. I don't recall seeing those here before. It could just be like a day old. The drift of blowing snow has covered them in. You can't see my footprints out here from 2 days ago. I'm looking for the tracks that come through here that I filmed. Whoa! That I filmed a few of the last time I was out here. They come right through here and down over the edge of the valley. Just not sure if the blowing snow has filled them completely in or not. That's not where they were. Came through back here somewhere. Right in here. See, you can just barely see where they were. So there's one right here, another one there, another one there, and way up there. Like, they are a major distance between them. It's like more than 5 feet. Like something ran through there. Something on two legs ran through the deep snow. They go across here and they curve. They cut across the trail over there where I was walking. So apparently, we do have something large living in our forest, even in the wintertime. I'm really curious about these caves though. There's no way I'm gonna go stick my head in a cave in the wintertime by myself. So it looks like I'm hearing something, but it's hard to say. There's so much noise up there. All these bloody trees are waving around. You know, all kinds of noise. Oh, it sounded like I was hearing something. This is kind of what it's like in the wintertime here, obviously. Come all the way out here. It's like you're usually a day late, or you're not in the right spot, or, you know, any multitude of things just don't go quite right. So you end up with spots like that, with the footprints. And you know, I just noticed the footprints didn't go anywhere. They just kind of come down the trail, and it looks like maybe they walked off over the edge of the cliff. But it's all blown in full of snow, and you can't tell. They're obviously not anywhere else. That was a person wearing snowshoes, whatever. You see his footprints all over out here. Right back to wherever he came from, or she came from. You just don't walk in the wilderness with snowshoes and just take them off. But those caves over there, I think this is an area I might want to monitor a little bit more closely. And look over there. See, there's a trail like what I'm walking on right now. It's like a line in the forest. I'm not sure if the camera can see. There's two of them. And they both go down right up and over the cave over there. So I think I've had enough time to recover to make it home. My problem is, I'm all sweaty. This is not really a winter coat, this is a raincoat. Just a sweater underneath it. And a t-shirt. Thanks for watching. Timber Giant Bigfoot.